the infectious disease program, as well as giving you the knowledge of the key infectious diseases that affect humans and their impact on human health, will also give you a number of, sort of transferable skills, including how to set up a research question, how to gather the evidence that's needed for research, how to critically analyse statistics, for example, and understand what's required to present evidence, and how to communicate all your findings and your knowledge to both an expert and perhaps a non-expert audience.
Once you've got those skills and that basis as a postgraduate certificate, we can then move on to postgraduate diploma and postgraduate and the master's degree, where you can choose your modules and go into a bit more detail about something you're particularly interested in. So that could be anything from malaria, HIV, bacterial infections, through to nutrition and infection, or vaccines. We also have the research element. So we have a module on research methods and analysis and management, and also the project, which is a really good training on how to approach research. So you have to write your own question, and how to then get that through all the different stages that you would need to do if you were then moving into research and academia as well.
You will have between 2 and 5 years to complete the programme. The programme is considered a part-time degree. So for example, if you are aiming to complete within 3 years, we would recommend that you aim to set aside approximately 20 hours a week between October and June to work through your study materials, prepare for the assignments, and revise and prepare for the time-constrained assessments.
Well, the distance learning aspect is really quite special in that you can study from wherever you are, you can study around your work situation, home situation, and other things that you're committed to doing in your life. As long as you're enthusiastic and self-motivated, then we have people who are doing everything from they've come straight out of a degree, so they might be doing their master's while they're working in a lab to get some money together or some experience. We also have people who are much further along their career path, and they've maybe been working for a few years, anything up to sort of 10, 15 years. We also have people who are quite involved in governance and policy, but they need to understand a bit more about what it is they're making decisions on. So they sometimes do our masters as well.
Whatever your motivation for undertaking the programme, we hope you find it engaging and stimulating. And we wish you every success in your studies and look forward to meeting you either virtually via our virtual learning environment or in person at one of our distance learning events or at one of the graduation ceremonies in the not too distant future.